गुड आफ्टरनून सबको, मेरा नमस्कार। दिस इज इंटरनेशनल मास्टर एंड फिडे सीनियर ट्रेनर शेखर साहब वेलकम्स यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स सोसाइटी ऑफ गुजरात एंड गुजरात स्टेट चेस सेशन टू दिस इंटरमीडिएट ट्रेनिंग सेशन। एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग सम एक्शन पैक्ड इंटरेस्टिंग गेम्स वेयर वन प्लेयर गेट्स एडवांटेज अर्ली इन द गेम एंड टेक्स स्ट्रांग इनिशिएटिव। Normally, the miniature games are resulted in the positional blunder or mostly 90% tactical blunder. A game collapses when a player makes a serious mistake in the early opening stage. So let's present to you first Kinderman versus Tessling. It is Sicilian Paulsen. हेलो रामकृष्ण, प्रियम चावड़ा, वत्सल पारिक, दीना पटेल एंड योगेश मंडलिक, वेलकम। सो दिस इज द पॉल्सन, सम पीपल कॉल इट कान। इफ आई इज नॉट पॉसिबल नाउ बिकॉज क्वीन एफ आई चेक, सो नाउ इफ आई इज अ थ्रेट। द मोर correct move here is to play queen e2. Okay, this is not bad either. I think the black should have done a quick castling with b7 and castle quickly. The opening has turned out to be a little better because white is having already a safe king and a little better center. So the advantage, but it is not great, it is minimum advantage plus equal. The idea is to play a4 b5, idea is to play queen to b3 sometime and some space. So now white enjoying space on the king side, like f4, rook f3, rook f3 can come. And black's counterplay is based only on the b4 weakness. So at right time, black must strike at d5. Otherwise, he will be very badly placed. But for that, he has to play queen to c7, rook d8. It is not easy. Before that, black, white comes on quickly. A prophylactic move, avoiding any kind of check in the diagonal. So white is having now dangerous threats. He wants to, the rook lift on third rank now, wants to bring rook g3, rook s3. Eventually white will strike e5, drive that knight from f6 and go for attack. Already five pieces of white are very strongly placed against black king. Sir, your network issue. No, my network is okay. My network is quite strong. Hello, Prince Gandhi. Why do we always choose Sicilian games where black gets crushed? No. It is not. It is misunderstood that Sicilian get crushed. But if you see the miniature games. Any open position, Sicilian is wide open game. It can happen in even e4 e5 game, open games. So it can happen in d4 games also. So basically I am showing you the typical mistakes where the game is wide open. When now Sicilian position, the game is wide open in the early stage of the game, so many open lines for both sides. So it is actually, you will find most many end games, they always say white winning. It is easy to set the board and it is easy to have a reason. So you will see 80% end games are white to play win, always will come. Or so combinations mostly white to play win. It is easy to set. So I am not telling that Sicilian is crushed. Sicilian is very good. So I am showing only open games. In open games, a small error becomes very serious. Okay, today I have kept some close games also. You will see some close games also. Like French, like Grunfeld, like Alekhine. Alright, now a rook lift of third rank has come. So the position is really good, prospective. Now a small error can be devastating. Black has mishandled the opening without any counterplay. So he's going to suffer. So trying to close the diagonal. Now already black is feeling the heat. Now the threat is just to, you know, how many pieces in attack? This bishop in attack. Okay, this bishop in attack. I must put like this. This bishop in attack. One. Now, you know, the rook is in attack. So, now the queen also in attack. So, eventually, the plan should be to play e5 or f5 at right time to open further. Now, black became panic. The position is bad, but it is not totally lost position. He can fight it out. Now, black played knight d7. It is a very bad move. Knight d7, it is a very bad move. Of course, the other alternative here, instead of playing knight d7, black can fight it out. Maybe I would say e5 will be giving a longer fight. Now, hello Devars. My network is okay. I think my network has no problem, Dina. So here, this is quite fast, I guess. The lag is only some 7 or 8 seconds. It is the position. What I am telling, it is relaying in nearly 8 to 10 seconds only, not much. Because I can see it here, not more than 8 to 10 seconds. Now, how should white continue? The position, now black has played Nd7, how should white continue now? Can somebody suggest how should white continue? I want participation so it becomes more interesting. I want you to participate to make the session more interesting. How should white continue now? Yogesh says rook into h7. Any other suggestion? Dina says e5. Okay, I have got two answers. Ramakrishna says e5. Any other suggestion? I have two answers, rook h7 and e5. Any other suggestion? Birabhadra says e5. You know, okay, I want you to get a feeling for the positions. My idea of selecting these games, there is a sudden death. e5 is okay, not a bad move, but it will continue for a longer period. After e5, the game will continue for a much longer period. But You make a move, white will resign. Instead of e5, what will force black to resign? Please think again, what will force black to resign? You make a white move, black will resign. Sudden death. It is sudden death. Knight e5. No. You have got some Q, knight e5, knight d5, but better knight b5. Better is knight b5. Okay. So, knight b5, finish. Of course, here, knight b5 is finished. Finished. Because if you play knight d5, is also possible, but I think that knight d5, there may be some chances. So this is finished. Resign. Because after pawn into queen h5. Queen h5 is finished. Pawn into rook check. It will get matted soon. Two or three moves. So here, of course, nd5 is also working, I think. Your nd5 is also working. But maybe here. Possible. Forced, I guess. I guess this is forced. Now still you can come here. nd5, nb5, both are working. Both are working. So let me take you to the next game. Finish. You take it checkmate. Bishop checkmate. Who should not miss? I mean to say, you have to totally focus. Your chess should be so strong, you must make precise finish. If it is finishing in two moves, you must not make 7-8 moves. Precise finish. You never know, counterplay will come at any time. This is Kalifman versus Nikolic. Main line, French defense, main variation. So here, castle. No threat yet. The position is very normal. Now, main idea of white is to create a weakness like h6 or g6. Pawn h6, g6 are very bad moves. So black should play either knight g6 or knight f5. Because if you play h6, eventually sacrifice will come. Or g6, queen h6 with the idea h4, h5. So black should play knight f5 or knight g6. Both are playable. So, okay. This is a bad move. A player should not make any move where opponent is strong. Without, suppose it is forced, you have to do it. So, f6 is not a forced move. The correct move was to play queen to a5. Definitely, queen a5 is better. Queen c7 is possible, but definitely this is a terrible move. How should white play now? Hello Mukund Agarwal, welcome. Yes, Ramakrishna, it is positional, but f6 is a bad move. Here, I would recommend Queen A5 is a good move. Even C4 is a good move. But definitely this is a terrible move. What should white do now? This is a serious mistake. Of course, black is not losing immediately, but it will collapsing slowly. Like four legs of a table, one leg is now very weak. It will collapse. Slok, hello Vires. F6 is thematic but not in this position. French defense, normally F6 break is coming normally, but not at this particular juncture. Here, I would say Queen F5 is a more correct move. Or, you play double pawn, C4 more correct move. Bad move. Now, this is giving a trouble. Now, the game will open up for white, pawn into. G5 has opened up. Forced. Now the game will collapse now. The position is lost. Immediate threat of bishop coming. Whatever you do, it is bad. But now this leads to sudden death. The only move. How white should continue now? Ramakrishna, I will show how black should have played in the game. I will discuss that black position was not bad. Without F6, I will show how he could have played. How should white finish the game? A quick finish. Show me. Hello, Parv Thakkar, Gursank. Today is a Thursday. Yesterday I tried to go for vaccine, but it was closed. And today is Shivaratri, so it is closed. So tomorrow morning, I have got my number for the vaccine for tomorrow morning. So I will not take the morning class tomorrow because I have to go for that COVID vaccine, which I could not do yesterday. Mukund Agarwal says Bishop G7. No. You do not clarify, you do not liquidate so quickly. You play KD2 now only. Mukund, KD2. Nothing better than development. Finish. It will lead to mate. It will lead to mate now. Now King H8, Queen H6 is finished. So, love over. The whole point is, where is the mistake? Here, the point is here, this one. This is normal diagram. I would say this is a dubious move. How could black play here? I will show some couple of French games. Now, Queen F5, Knight F5, Knight F3, C4. Now, if you retreat, it is passive. Now, Queen F5. Only move. And now, Queen check. Now, this looks terrible. The position looks terrible for black. There is a mate threat and Queen threat. Now, the Queen is under attack and also there is a mate threat. But mind you, black is exchanged out. So, he can return some of the material. The position, I think black can defend. Show me your defensive power now. Now, show me the defensive power. How can black defend? French and Caro Kann are really good. I play both. And it is not easy. But you need to defend at right time. For example, the first move is forced. You have to play g6. g6 is forced. And now he plays queen. Idea, queen f6 and bishop h6. With the idea, he wants to play queen bishop h6, queen f6. So, how can black defend? The threat is clear. Queen to f6, bh6. And queen is under attack. Karna kya hai? g6, queen h4. Now, white has got two type of attack. Now, white is preparing knight g5. White is preparing queen f6, bh6. Do threat hai. Never underestimate the defense. It is, you know, it looks everything is over. Not really. What should black do? There is defense. Please find out the defense. Defense is here. Queen h1. Now, Yogesh, queen h1. And what will you do for queen f6? Yogesh, what will you do for queen f6? Dina says queen into h1. Okay, chalo, main maarta hoon queen into h1. Suppose, let us say you take queen h1. Now, I will have to put it in mode. Now you play queen f6. Ab kya karoge? What will you do now? Attacking or defending, your attack or defense, you have to be very cool. While you are defending or you are attacking, nerves must be cool. Very well, Shlok. Shlok says correct move. Now, queen into, knight into d4. Forced pawn into, everything is controlled. There is no mate now. अभी कुछ नहीं होगा. आई डोंट हैव टू टेक एंड गोट एंड ऑफ द अटैक. नाउ द बिशप इज अंडर अटैक. व्हाइट किंग इज एक्सपोज. सो एक्सचेंज डाउन. फॉर बीइंग एक्सचेंज डाउन व्हाइट हैज नॉट इनफ कंपनसेशन. कुछ नहीं मिलेगा. वेयर लॉस्ट. नो अटैक. Also, there is not necessarily knight f5, he can also play another game like knight g6. Like here he can play also knight g6. Now knight g6 is okay. Idea knight g5. Now the point is, why black is preparing second rank defense. Second rank defense. Okay. If you play ng5, he can play a move like h6 is possible. No, not a problem. This is everything okay. Queen f5 is coming and the white attack will now rebuffed. This is no problem. Okay. So, black should have played ng6, or if I play knight f5, then you should play like Sabalov. See, either you play like Sabalov here, like knight f5, okay. Knight f5 is okay. There is knight f5. Knight f5 is okay. check, and now g6. He can defend. Caro Kann is positional, but French gives winning chances. In Caro Kann, the problem is white enjoys lot of space. So many times a player who is not ambitious, he will give a hard time because he will try to set a drawn position, equal position, lot of space, whereas French, it is very volatile. Caro Kann is solid, but French gives more winning chances, also losing chances. Caro Kann, losing chances are less, winning chances are also less. But Karpo has won many games, positionally fantastic. Again, white is Garry Kasparov, black is none. So, we have got Grunfeld by transposition. D6 will be King's Indian, so this will lead to Neo Grunfeld. Actually, you know, Kasparov was the biggest expert of King's Indian in 1980s. And he had problem with Karpo in the World Championship match. Karpo gave him a hard time with this classical Fianchetto 2 systems. So Kasparov resorted to Neo Grunfeld. Okay, but he knew both sides of it very well. Now black to play. The black's correct move is to play Nc6. Blacks now, he should play Nc6. White is slightly better, but he castle. Nc6 is more correct. This is more to the point. Castle. How should white play? Ganpat ho gaya. Bombay ka topori language. Just for fun. So here, because he has not played Nc6, white can castle, but he plants the knight on e5. Now, if black plays Nc6, knight into c6 will give a weakness on the open file. Now, Nc6 positional inferior. Okay. Now, castle. Now you have to dislodge the knight, because of inaccuracy in opening, white has advantage. So black played knight d7. How should white play now? Hello, Sritu Nandi. The point is, offering, exchanging a piece is a very common thing you will face every time in the game. Exchange to karna hai, but the way you want, he wants to exchange, play f4. Now, if you take f into e5 with a positional advantage. So, takes, clear a better game for white. Now, white position is superior, no doubt, because the position of the rook, you know, the position of the rook, position of the bishop, the center, white has enjoying advantage. When you have advantage, you should take the initiative in every game, whether it is basketball, football, hockey, any game, you have advantage, you should take initiative. So also in chess, if you do not take initiative, advantage chala jaye. So initiative lena hai, to strike. Now you have to strike at center, e4. e4. Fine move by Garry Bhai Kasparov. Marna to padega. Bishop e3. Now white center is fantastic. Ye to ja raha hai. जा रहा है। अरे ये फंटास्टिक। नाउ ब्लैक इज लिटिल बैड, सो वट एवर इट इज ही मस्ट कंप्लीट डेवलपमेंट, ही मस्ट कंप्लीट डेवलपमेंट। बट ब्लैक प्लेइंग विथ फायर, व्हेन ओपोनेंट इज हैविंग इनिशिएटिव एंड वेरी एग्रेसिव पोजिशन, यू वॉन्ट टू ओपन द गेम, इट इज सुइसाइड। ऑन पास, नाइट इंटू पॉन, क्वीन इंटू, नाउ टेकिंग द पॉन इज वेरी वेरी रिस्की। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू गिव द डार्क स्क्वायर बिशप, देन योर ब्लैक किंग विल बी टेरिबल विदाउट द डार्क स्क्वायर बिशप, एंड इफ यू प्ले नाइट इंटू पॉन, अ पिन इज कमिंग, द पिन इज कमिंग, सो इट इज लॉस्ट ओनली। नाउ इट इज जस्ट अ बैड पोजिशन इन द अरे वॉट हैपन, वॉट हैपन हियर, वॉट हैपन, कंट्रोल वन, अरे ये क्या हो गया सब, कंट्रोल वन, सो नाउ नाइट इन टू पॉन हिट टू रूक डी वन फिनिश, ओनली मूव ई फाइव, नाउ नाइट जी फाइव, देर इज नो आंसर, ही इज हैविंग अ थ्रेट ऑफ बिशप डी फाइव चेक, क्वीन कमिंग हियर, बिशप डी फाइव इज नॉट देर, द क्वीन इज कमिंग, सो ही कैनॉट डिफेंड, इफ यू डिफेंड सी फोर बी डी फाइव चेक, नाइट ई सिक्स फेल्स, रिजाइन्स। सो what we learn from the game, when we get a good position, we should take initiative, and who are the great players in the world champion, among the world champion, number one Bobby Fischer, then Garry Kasparov, or you say Garry Vai Kasparov, then Mikhail Tal, above all the king of all, the king of all initiative, Mikhail Tal, Boris Pasky, extraordinary grandmasters, when they get initiative, just kill, no matter who is on the other side, the entire world, they finish the game. Other grandmaster like Geller, like Lubozovic, like Velimirovic, you know, Viswanathan Anand, great with initiative. Next, Caro Kann, it is better to play, modern players play Nd2 here, this is a better move. Why? Because Nd2 you have nothing better than pawn into pawn, but if you play Nc3 a new variation can come, he can play here g6, and now white should play h3, knight f3, then black gets bg4, now bishop g7, you know, his idea is to take this and the pressure comes. This is the drawback. Then that is why here you have to play h3 to maintain the small advantage. Why waste a time move when you play nd2 h3 is not necessary. So why should you play nc3 and h3? That is why modern grandmaster play here nd2. So let us see the game. Pawn into, knight into. So this is called Larsen and Bronstein, they preferred this, whereas Korchnoi and Tartakovor, they preferred pawn into. Tartakovor, Korchnoi, they used to play like this. Bronstein and Larsen used to play like this. I prefer this towards center. This is center. Now the theoretical move is bishop f5, bishop f5 followed by e6. Black must play now. This is the only other moves are bad. He has to play bf5. You know, for example, more modern players, they play here knight. No, not at this point. not at this point. They play here directly knight. Now bishop f5. Then they play g3. Now a trap. And then white black is winning. It happened in one of the national premier game. National premier this happened. Yes. So in the game here he played c3. Bishop f5 is only correct move. Bad move. I don't understand why he has to play with a passive bishop when you can play bf5. Now already the position is inferior for black. Naturally, he don't want counterplay, so he will play d5. Now black is badly placed. How should white play now? White has a huge advantage. You have to take the initiative. Now, you need to open up the game, f4. If pawn takes pawn, simply castle. Now, too slow, this is too slow. Now, b5 is coming, but it is white to play. Takes b3. Other moves are just bad. B5 losing to d6 and bishop into d6 and thereafter it is just crushing. After bd6 you have got rook into f6. This is bad. He played in the game pawn into. White to play and win. Please find out. Simply the knight should come. Simply knight should come. Idea knight e4 crossing. It is better resign. Now knight into d6. Rook into f7 is a direct threat. He cannot castle. That will lead to mate. Oh, rook into winning. It is very poorly played by black. Normally black is a very strong GM, you know, you rarely find Rosolimo in such kind of worst situation. F4 gone. So the whole idea, I will tell you, this opening itself is a mistake. I believe the variation is okay, this line is okay. No, d4 is okay, this position. This is okay line. This is the best move. It's not that easy. Now bf5. This is how he should play. Okay, going to the next. It is not scavenging. Normally knight to f6 there. So this sort of positions normally is not good to delay the development. Now he is inviting b5. Six moves over, not even one piece has come. It's not a good idea. He is ignoring the kingside development also. Now, if you play b4, you have no time, because I will ask to refer the game. White is Fischer, black is Nasdorf. Nasdorf took the pawn and suffered 25 moves, he lost to Fischer. b4, now if you play b4, knight a4, and bishop into pawn will be worse. Okay, I will tell you the variation. Now, bishop into pawn. Knight into. If queen e7, knight d5 is coming. Queen e7 is very bad on because of knight d5. So only move. Force rather. Now the king cannot castle. It is now hardly, if black is, white is a pawn or one or two pawn down, the position is terrible for black. Now it is like that, piece for two pawns. White has two pawns in return for his piece, but black cannot castle and it is terrible. Tempo, you get another tempo, BE3, BD4, tempo. Some queen E2, tempo. Now, do not play defensive chess like rook coming to D1, instead bishop D4. Queen into pawn is not possible. This is taboo. Queen into pawn, knight is, C7 is coming. Sorry, I made a wrong arrow. Now, queen takes pawn, suppose you do, knight check is coming. That means knight into pawn is also bad. Now, just pawn into knight, open the rook line. Into, f6, g7, h8. Check. Now, queen into queen is met with check. This is lost check. Another new queen coming. So, this is the result. When you do not develop a piece early in the game, just make pawn moves, these are bad. This is terrible. This sort of moves, now for example here, a player can play g6, another pawn move. These are bad moves. So d6. Now another pawn move. These are bad things. And still he is ignoring kingside. Knight f6 is still white better after knight f6, and white stands better. White can play here f4. Ignore the defense. White can play f4. Now if you play b4 and knight will come, and now knight into pawn is bad. Because you know f5 can come. You can't play bishop d5 will come. So this is bad. Development is on priority, especially king. You cannot play underdeveloped and just get sort of this sort of moves. Hello, Nenuji. So we have a Grunfeld, Neo Grunfeld. Both are legendary players. Both are great. All standard theory. In my opinion, white is slightly better. Center. And little ahead in development. Now, it is best black should play knight c6. Blacks, knight c6 with roughly equal chances. But black played became more ambitious. Knight c6. Little better for white, but bad move, queen f5. Now this is NC6 position is little better for white, a bad move. What he could do here? Now, he should try to play Nd7 and e5. Nd7 probably is the safest way, bishop g4, a player, average player will play bishop g4. He play Nd7, preparing to hit the center. But a bad move. Queen f5. A naturally, bishop d2, you cannot play. So, very ambitious move. Still, bishop g4 was called for. A bad move. I think the game is losing now. Already the position, this is the drawback. This is the drawback. He will suffer. So white exploits it. Forced pawn c4. Now, knight b5 comes with a tempo. You defend c7. If you go back, queen b7 is very bad position. So, only move a3, knight is trapped. So, actually, normally we do not get such positions, but I just tell you that bringing the queen and putting in a jeopardized position, it is really bad, and that is not expected from such a legendary great player. See, I will show you the game, similar structure, white was Samkovich, and black was Karpov. Maybe I will show you that game now, because it is not, I will not get the reference otherwise. There is some quiz. Samkovich and black was Karpov. So, we will play, if you play d5, the position will turn out to be same thing. So here, actually, I want you to find out anything wrong with queen f5. Now, when white is playing bishop a3, is there anything wrong with this move? Then why bishop a3? Is he inviting queen f5? Tracking and analyzing all of Victor Korsunov from start to finish. Actually, you don't have to. Because there is already CD, Korsunov as white, Korsunov as black. Already there has been a file, Korsunov with white, Korsunov with black. Okay, please find out what is wrong with queen f5. Why queen f5 is a bad move? Can you somebody tell me why queen f5 is a bad move? Why? Yes, Korsunov is white, Korsunov is black, already file is there, and if a player studies that, he will improve tremendously. Tremendous improvement. Okay, I want you to get a feeling for position. The queen f5 is a bad move. Why? Why queen f5 bad move? Ramakrishna says queen b3. Any alternative? Any alternate move? Yes, self-help is best, no doubt. What is wrong with queen f5 here? Why queen f5 bad move? No. Viraj says knight e5. Knight e5. And if I take it, what is wrong? Hello, Mayor Chaudhary. Knight e5, I will take queen in 2. So, what will you do, Vires? Bb5 check and winning the game. Bb5 check and winning, because after the bishop move, he will play knight c4. The queen is trapped. The queen is trapped. That is why Anatoly Karpo did not play. He played queen. And now bishop ready to castle. Now rook. And next move pawn b6. Equal. The position has equalized. This is how black should have played in the Gelfand game. The structure is same in the Gelfand game. This is what should have happened with equal chances. And Karpo went on to win the game. Now this is went on to win. Okay, I leave this. If you study a player of your style, I suggest a player with positional style should follow two players, rather four players. One, number one, Kramnik, Karpo, then I would say Svyazlov, Petrosian. These are pure positional player. Dynamism is there. They don't play dull game. The outside it look dull, but their fantastic dynamism is there. And if you want fighting chess, Korsunoi, no compromise, always wants to win against anybody. Fighting player, Viktor Korsunoi. If you want attack, complication, Tal, Velimirovic, all-rounder like Fischer, Anand. Great attacking players are Spassky, Alekhine, Keres. Okay. So we have got a Paulsen. This is a very ambitious line, not the right. More correct and scientific is Nb d7 and b6. Nd7, you have to take over protect the e5 point. Nd7 and b6, bb7, more scientific, little rash move, only move. So he takes initiative, exploiting this e5. Necessary. Nd5 is positionally bad, and now white makes a very clever move. Of course, pawn takes knight, bishop into be3, you can get little better game, plays a very safe way. Bishop into knight, now pawn into, bishop into, the intermediate, because after you play pawn into, then bishop into, bishop is coming, Nd5 is coming. So, he eliminates the bishop. So white to play, how to exploit this position? Vires, games of Lasker and Capablanca, the openings are outdated. There were those games you enjoy the middle game and end game, especially the end game. Lasker was great in defense, Capablanca was great in middle game and end game. Bishop f4, knight e4, finish. Now if you will play this here, you can just play bishop to h6 followed by knight g3 and knight f5, crossing. Then knight f5 will, no, not sorry, not this one, knight g3 and knight f5 will cross. This is devastating. Defend the f6 point. So he plays in the game bishop. How to white to play and win? White is winning now. How? Yes, you can study the games of Korsunoy. I liked Korsunoy. I studied some of his in my early career. I studied Korsunoy. It benefited me very good. 400 best games of Korsunoy, a great book. Now knight into pawn and bishop into e5. Knight into f6 and bishop into e5 crossing. You see, I am having the file. I will tell you, these are all prepared file. For example, here, this is Korsunoy is white. This is black wins. This is black wins only Korsunoy. Black wins only Korsunoy. All Korsunoy is black wins. And this is all white wins of Korsunoy. So, if you study, it will be great. Any great player, it will help you. Efim Geller, another great legend. Efim Geller was a great attacking player and great in opening, and he defeated all world champions of his time. Four times, including Fischer, Smyslov, Botvinnik, Spassky, Tal, Petrosian, everybody. All the world champions of his time, he defeated four times. He could not become world champion because one serious drawback. He used to come in deep time trouble, all the game, always time trouble. He used to think deep about sacrifices, always come in time trouble. And Geller's contribution that he showed the chess world how the King's Indian defense should be played. He taught the chess world, rather. Botvinnik said, Geller taught us how to play the King's Indian. So he was a specialist. Sicilian, King's Indian, all theory, he was great and great attacking player. So in this game, his opponent is British GM Michael Steen. So a Marokzi bind. A bad move. It is better to play bishop g7 and castle. Bad move. One of the idea of black castle, bishop e6 and nd5. Now knight h5 can come, so it just moves the queen. Bad move. A player should castle quickly. Bad move. Now, if you play short castle, knight d5 will come. Short castle can be met with knight d5. Another bad move. The king in center. King in center. Unprotected queen. White is winning. White is just winning. So, not winning, I would say, clearly better. Now, this is a suicide. This is grabbing the pawn is suicide. How white should win the game? अभी कैसल कर लेना चाहिए था. कैसल के बाद नाइट d5 आएगा, क्वीन d8 बैक. नाउ कैसल नाउ nd5 थ्रेट आएगा. सो यू शुड नाउ प्ले, बट हियर ही प्लेड दिस बैड मूव, बिशप इनटू पॉन. हाउ टू विन? व्हाइट इज विनिंग. फाइंड आउट, पनिश ब्लैक फॉर दिस एडवांचर. White will punish for black's advantage. So he played simply knight d5. Now queen into queen, he will come into trouble. Queen into queen, there is problem on the bishop. So queen takes pawn. How should white play now? Please make a note that tomorrow morning there will be no class. I could not take the vaccine yesterday, so I have to go tomorrow morning appointment for the COVID-19 first dose. So tomorrow morning I cannot take class. I will be, if my there is some fever comes, if there is no fever, I will come in the afternoon. Otherwise I will not take morning afternoon also. Normally after the vaccine some fever comes sometimes. ये गणपत हो गया है, ऑलरेडी ब्लैक गणपत हो गया. नॉट ई डी फाइव. बिशप इंटू सी फोर में गणपत हो गया. बिशप इंटू सी फोर नाउ रुक इंटू एंड क्वीन डी फाइव हो गया. काम खत्म हो गया. अभी रूक इज डबली अटैक. ही कैंट प्ले बी फाइव बिकॉज क्वीन ए फाइव क्वीन ए एट चेक इज देयर. सो ही प्लेड दिस मूव रिजाइन बिकॉज आफ्टर यू प्ले रूक हियर यू कैन नीड नॉट एक्सचेंज क्वीन. रूक चेक मे बी क्वीन चेक एंड नाउ दिस इज ऑल ओवर इन द गेम. ही रिजाइन बिकॉज किंग हियर queen into d7 lead to checkmate attack. So ये जो है king को center में रख के ये सब नहीं करना है. ये all this thing he should not do all this thing in concert. This is a terrible move. Bishop c4 horrible move. He should play castles. White is little better, that's all. Hello Dr. Sanapati, good afternoon. Grandmaster Geller, I drew 2 times when he came to India. 2 tournaments, I played 2 draws. Okay. Sozin attack. Now, more to the point here, okay. Here actually f4 is there. After f4, now you can play queen b6 also is possible here. This is also possible. Okay. Now we place castle. This is possible. After queen b6, bishop comes. And queen b7. This is possible. Anyway, white is better here, but this is a variation. You should know about it. Bishop c5. Knight comes. White is very strong here. Idea, knight on knight, queen check is there. But it is turning out badly. Now, maximum development. Anyway, you are losing a piece. So, why not develop? Now, if you play queen into king h1, the bishop remains under attack. So, initiative. Very big initiative. How should white play now? Okay, maybe I will make one more move. Okay. How should white play? एक्चुअली यू नो गणपत हो गया मीन्स बेसिकली यू मस्ट नो बॉम्बे में गणपति 10th डे विसर्जन करते हैं समुन्द्र में नदी में, उनको डुबा देते हैं। तो बॉम्बे में डूबने वाला आदमी को गणपत हो गया बोलते हैं, डूबने वाला मजाक करते हैं गणपत, डूबने वाला आदमी को गणपत हो गया बोलते हैं। तो जब किंग डूब जाता है, क्वीन डूब जाता है, तो गणपत हो गया। जस्ट वन हाउ टू प्ले वेरी सिंपल मूव क्वीन ए ब्लंड मिस्टेक ए सीरियस मिस्टेक नाउ ए प्लेयर शुड नॉट ग्रैब मटेरियल विदाउट थिंकिंग वाई दिस इज लूजिंग दिस इज लॉस्ट एट द मोमेंट ही शुड हैव प्लेड बिशप सी फाइव बिशप सी फाइव व्हाइट इज बेटर बट नॉट इजी बट आफ्टर द मूव नाइट ई फाइव व्हाइट इज विनिंग हाउ इमीडिएटली विनिंग अरे बाबा आपको ये मूव के लिए टेम्पो चाहिए यू कैन नॉट डू बिकॉज ऑफ द मेट तो मेट को बीच में कुछ कर दो तो रुक कैसे आ जाएगा अभी जस्ट प्ले बिशप डी फाइव बिशप डी फाइव क्वीन से तो नहीं मार सकता है पॉन से मारा रुक स्त्री खत्म खत्म हो जाए मेट सो ए प्लेयर मस्ट बी विजिलेंट अबाउट ऑल दिस थिंग सो बिशप सी फाइव दिस विल नॉट हैपन Because a check is coming. French defense. I would say Taras is a positional torture to French player. I don't mind playing French against NC3 because there is a lot of life for both sides. Very volatile position comes. Sharp attack comes, defense comes, but ND2 is very slow and very difficult for French players, a positional treatment. There are two lines, on ND2, this is called Taras, black has C5 or knight F6. So when I play French, somebody plays ND2, I like to play knight F6 because I feel that this is very dull, isolated pawn. And draw is maybe white is little better. So IQP comes for black. And this one, classical, is more aggressive. So I would recommend if you are more ambitious, play knight f6 here. And if you are not so ambitious, c5. Pawn into pawn. Here white gets some tempo. Castle. Knight b3. Now the position that pawn will fall, but white has 2-3 options. White can play queen to e2, white can play queen e2 with the idea. Now white can play rd1 and take the pawn. He can play rd1 and knight into d4. This is an idea of Russian grandmaster Ivar Gitlis. Basically Russian, he is from Latvia. Tal ka gaon wala hai, Riga. Tals, Riga. So Ivar Gitlis prepared queen e2 with the idea he wants to bring the rook to d1 and knight d4. This is his plan. But because after queen e2, you know, now queen e2, maybe you can come over here. Now rook here. Okay. Now castle. Now knight, maybe here knight into or this knight into. Maybe knight into, and rook into. This is quite sharp position. But I guess there is some definitely improvement for black. So here knight into pawn. Simply bb2 and completing development. The position white stands better. Better center, e5 is very indirectly controlled, and development also. Good move. I would say good move because knight g4 is coming. You cannot dislodge the knight. This is in fact, I like it. This is a good move by black. So white played here knight f3, defending in advance. Now, I think black position is active, is not bad. How should black play now? A French player will know quickly how black should play. Logically, black is under download. He must establish coordination. Very normal. This is a simple move, and after that, the game is only marginally better for white. After bishop f4, the position is only little better for white. But he made a bad move. Bd6 would have given very good chances, fighting chances, but a bad move. Now what has happened? White is now vastly downlocked. And now Bd6 not working. Why this is a bad move? Can somebody tell me? Why now the position is very bad for black? Why? Find out about it. No, no, Namukishta, alternate, it is, knight f7 is not best, no, 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 you find out the finish, the game is finishing in only two moves, only two moves. Not knight f7. I tell you, the game finish in two moves. No, no, no. Birabhadra or Ramakrishna, knight f7 is a better move. Hai. The game finishing in two moves. Knight f7, he will play bishop check. There is finish. Very good. Who says Yogesh? Knight into g4, right move, knight into g4, winning. You have to take, and now if you take it, pawn into bishop check is winning. Now king here, or you take it, it doesn't matter. You king here, rook into winning. Or you take, doesn't matter. If you take it also losing, take it also loses, check. And this is falling. And king moves, rook into. So, you need to finish the game in style. Sudden death. Sudden death. However, I will tell you, I prefer, abhi it is a matter of choice. Abhi at the moment, c5, I prefer here knight f6 if I am playing black. And now there are two lines. This is one line. This is a called classical main line. And other line is to play bd3. Ne2, bd3. This is the second line. This is more piece play. A player wants piece play as white will play bd3. A player wants some positional pressure f4. In both cases, black has got a lot of complications. But I think c5, I feel that white is very comfortable after c5. This is Quinteros, Miguel Quinteros.
All of you know that I told some story. Queen g4. This is bad. A player should not go after pawn hunting in opening. Now the correct move, knight c6, knight f6, e6, b7, castle. Or g6, bg7. You should play knight c6 here. Knight c6, castle. Now g6, bg7, knight f6, castle. Or knight f6, e6, castle. But this is bad. Bad. Why? Castle. Now he has made the third queen move. And he has to make another queen move. Three queen moves already. Now knight c3 is coming. Another tempo. Four queen moves already. Arre babre, it is too much. Five queen moves. Itna digest nahi kar payega. Abhi ye to gaya. Abhi dono ye ganpat ho jayega aur ye bhi ganpat ho jayega. Panch se queen move nahi kar sakta hai. White to play and win now. Find out. Play like Walter Brown. Six queen move, it is too much. Six queen moves in opening without development. अभी बस आपको development करके finish करना है. Tempo पे tempo और tempo. Knight a3 tempo. जाओ queen. So seventh queen move. 10 move में 7 queen move है. अभी rook c1 आना बाकी है. Rook c1 आना बाकी हो गया. खेलो if है. अभी 8th queen move. This is too much. No, knight f5 का जरूरत नहीं है. Normal. Knight f5 नहीं, knight. Idea knight into pawn threat. Idea, I am giving a threat. तो e5 करेगा. उसको ही मारो. Check. So, 8 queen moves. What will you do now? After 8 queen moves, what will you do? White to play and show me the finish. Black is not a beginner. Black is a strong GM. But it happens sometime. Black, it happens sometime. Okay, white to play and win. Yes, अभी तो गणपत हो गया, लेकिन कैसा करोगे? Already 8 queen moves, कैसा जीतोगे? Very simple way. Now 9th queen move, rook d5, rd5. 9th queen move. 15 move में 9 queen moves. Very good. No, if you play other move, there is no square. There is no square, only move. 9 queen moves. He can resign. Now, pawn threat, queen threat. Resign. After knight into, mate into. After knight into, checkmate in 2 moves. And after king into, some rook check and also mate. Rook check and mate. So, and rook d5 is over. So, this is 9 queen moves is too much. I believe, ये जो line है, take. Now, this is simple line. Black is quite good, nothing wrong. Knight c3, now g6, bishop here, now knight here, and castle. Little slight better for white. You are going to tell the story of gold coin game. Gold coin game is basically, you know, Frank Marshall was American champion. In those days, people wanted only brilliancy. They wanted attack on the king. So, Marshall was a brilliant player. He never missed mate in 3, mate in 4, mate in 5. In his entire life, he never missed mating attack. But his main problem was endgame. If Marshall was very good in endgame, he could have been a candidate for world championship. But his endgame was not as per his strength in opening and middle game. So always he used to lose to Capablanca. Always. I think the score was some 18-2 or 18-1, I'm not sure. 18 for Capablanca and 2 for Marshall. Okay, so Marshall played a game, the queen on g3, which was attacked by 3 black pieces, 2 pawns and knight. Still hit 3 or 4 attacks that the queen could not be captured. So they call it, people threw some gold coins on the board. In those days, the money was in small gold coins. There was, so people threw some gold coin. Theoretical line, I will check. I will check the theoretical line. So, here, I will check the theoretical line. Maybe I don't have here. Probably. Maybe I will see informator. Yes, if you see lot of line, Kasparov is white. Theory is the boss. Theoretical. So white maintains a small edge. Not ready to exchange pieces and bind. No, I would see, this is not suitable for all, because I recommend to players which are more solid. Here you need to calculate lot of variations, so I would not recommend this. Yeah. This. White stands better, technically plus. So, black is a very active player, so he is breaking the bind. Pawn into pawn is bad, because you lose your advantage after knight d5, knight b4. So, it is a bad move, that's why Ivan Chuk played here c5. Maintaining a queenside majority. 1, 2, 3 versus majority, and the pawn remains bad. This is a bad pawn here. So this position slightly better for white. Okay. Not this line. Okay. Which line you want? This is plus, slight better for white. Let us see Kasparov. Yeah, his position is some now counterplay is there. So typical breaking the bind. He's breaking the bind. Okay, I will discuss this line later on. Okay, let me finish this games. Actually, I am afraid tomorrow, if I go for the vaccine at 10:30, 11, and they give me, and I have to wait there for 1 hour. If I get fever, I think I should cancel the tomorrow afternoon, because I have to come and take rest and lunch. I don't think so. Maybe tomorrow I will not have any class. Because of the COVID vaccine, first dose, I will take my next class on Saturday morning. So friends, I will not take any class tomorrow, because I am afraid I will have to hurry up, and then all this thing will be too tight. I will discuss the line later, Ramakrishna. Okay, wo khana mangta hai, the bots are asking, give me 1 minute please, 1 minute. Okay. I will discuss this line later. Carpesco, it is Bellico, is a very strong GM. Sicilian scavenging, Sozin attack. Mixing of Keras and Sozin attack. Now, this is playing with fire. Now, grabbing the pawn underdeveloped. White has so many open lines. This is very risky business. Now, agreed that center is gone, but king side. Now, you are anyway winning a piece, so destroying the castle. White to play and find a winning plan. White is having a fantastic winning attack. How should you do that? Please check. I will write back from washroom. Please check. How should white play? Right. Let me see the finish, how you have got it. Yes, I like that. Yogesh, RD1 check, RG1 check. Dina Patel, congratulations. Bishop D3 and RG1. And take. Now, I just sacrifice so that you take queen check and rook G1. And if you do not take rook G1. Now, lost position. You cannot take that, only move. Bishop D3, Yogesh. King into Rook G1. Finish. Idea, Queen S3 mate. Now there is a sudden death. Now there is a sudden death. How do you do that? can somebody show me sudden death? White brings a sudden death to black. बस अभी आपको नाइट एफ थ्री नाइट जी फाइव फिनिश है. नाइट एफ थ्री बिशप को गार्ड करो. एन एफ थ्री डिफेंड द बिशप. क्वीन एफ सिक्स इज मेट बाय बिशप डी फोर एंड क्वीन इन टू बी टू ऑल्सो बी डी फोर. लॉस्ट लॉस्ट सडन डेथ. It's a Karokan advanced variation. This is bad. Normally a player must play in general. This is the main line and the best line. All other moves are not good. Bad move. Now white wants to play bishop. Black wants to play bishop d7. No, bishop and knight. Bishop d4. And white advantage is clear. White's extra pawn is now maintained. Now this is bad. How many knight moves? Three knight moves. Now the correct capture is queen into. This is a bad move. You know, if pawn into, black will get counterplay with b6. B6. And b4, a5. Counterplay. That is why the correct move is queen into. Queen into. Now stopping b4, but then anyway, it is too slow, lost. a3. Now he wants to stop castle. So knight. This is the correct way to play. In c3 is bad because of bishop into b4. So how should white play now? The threat is to play bishop into pawn. The threat is bishop into pawn now. Why I am unable to do it? This is the threat. What should white do? No, not NB3. You see, always look for active move. Abhi threat de raha hai. Don't defend. First you find, do you have any active move? If you no active move, then defend. No, Viresh, not NB3. Always active move first. If no active move, only I will defend. Find the active move for white. Dina Patel, congratulations. Knight c3. Very well. Now bishop into pawn will not work. Why? Pawn b7. This pawn is ready. He can come any moment. That is why. Now bishop rook into. Bishop into pawn will fail. Bishop into pawn, then b7.
winning. So bishop into pawn means knight into rook and queen into. So here he plays knight c3, rook into, but intermediary move. I cannot take because my rook is hanging, but this intermediary move. डिजाइन या तो क्वीन होगा या रूक फ्री लेगा. चॉइस इज योर्स. अलाउ मी क्वीन और अलाउ मी ए फ्री रूक. वेल डन दीना पटेल. अभी ये गेम आई विल एनालाइज. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वेरिएशन. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग लाइन. कैसल. Now the idea, if you take the bishop right away, it is bad. You take it, he will take, and queen h4 will come next. Knight cannot move. H file open ho gaya, knight moves, this will kill. That's why you cannot take it. But d3, idea, and d2 will come. Queen. With the idea, black's plan is to play knight here, then knight here, and then knight here. This is the idea. So knight d2. Now the variation goes like rook e1 and now knight b3. Now why knight b3? Because if you castle, it is bad. If you castle, I will take it. Now the knight will come, and if you play queen h4, the knight is coming. This is a one possibility, and there is, because now the threat is coming, there is a threat now. So this is one. That is why rook e1. That is why rook e1 has been played. And now, by the way, a player can play bishop c5. Bishop c5. Now you can play d4. No. Bishop c5, re1. How am I missing this line? Variation. One minute. Yeah, I think bishop c5. I think nd2. Nd2. I think castle. Castle, then you should play d4. Pawn into pawn, and now I can take it. Why d4? Because the bishop line must be closed. So d4. Now pawn into. You can play knight. Idea queen h4 does not work. Queen check. This is the point. Now rook into does not work, king into and come back. So the d4 is the move that stops all kind of attacking chances. This is the lovely move. Anyway, I will come to the actual game. This line. Now he wants to come quickly. D4. I think this is bad. He wants to sacrifice a piece on h3, but black will take the piece and run away. Now, if necessary, black will return the extra piece, and now black will run away. Now, if you play gf3, it is not working. I return the piece. There is the attack. No attack. Even if you play queen h6, there is no attack. Queen check also no attack. I will take the knight. So there is no attack. Gf3, and if you play bb4, pinning, run away. Check, you will run away. If check, run away. A bishop into knight he will run bishop into and bishop interpose. End of the attack. So this variation, we have to be very careful. White will take and he will return the material. I read the whole variation written by Lazos Fortis, I think. Lazos Fortis. In his book, How to Open a Chess Game by 7 Grandmasters. Fantastic book. Learning a lot of basics. Who are the Grandmasters? Larry Evans, Gligoric, Hort, Fortis, Larsen, Paul Keres. These are the Grandmasters. In my opinion, best is to play here f3, queen d2, bc4, castle. This is just waiting. A bad move. A beginner's blunder. King f8 only move. Now, the position, the white black king position is very bad. And the rook is ready. The rook is already in the line. This is a bad position already. How white should play? White has got advantage. But what would you do now? क्या करोगे भाई अभी? दीना, नाइट c3 इज ऑलरेडी देयर. अभी नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस, द बिशप इज डूइंग नथिंग. यू नीड टू फोकस ऑन दिस स्क्वायर, सो द बिशप विल डू द जॉब. सो एम्प्लॉय द पीसेस इन द इफेक्टिव स्क्वायर्स. बिशप c4 थ्रेट. क्या करेंगे? Now creating another threat. Idea, now knight into d6 is a threat. Now he is giving a new threat. Knight into d6. Are you? Threat. Anyway. Because after queen into, queen will be unprotected. Rook f7 and bishop check. Knight into. After queen into queen, mating attack will come. After queen exchange, the mate continues without queen. Finishing the game. Rook attack, f7 attack. So queen exchange will not survive. After knight into this, but then queen check and leading to mate. Only move. No, there is no need to wait. Bishop into queen is okay, but this is finishing the game. Bishop into queen, you win material, but not finish. This is finish. Now only move king into. Now queen into c8. Picking another piece. So a player should not play such bad adventure. Knight g4. Like beginner's moves. A dragon player should never do that. This sort of moves. This is terrible. What is this? This is ng4. Horrible move. What is that? Where is that move? This move. This is a terrible move. The player cannot, you know, neglecting the. I read one book by Nunn. What is the name of the book? Understanding Chess, I think. Understanding Chess, move by move, name of the book. Nunn has written lot of good books, And in that book, he analyzes this variation, which is, he says, it is not good but playable. I feel it is very bad. B5. Now, with the idea C5, you have a Sicilian type of position avoiding theory. C5 and pawn into pawn, if this is allowed, rook C8 will come with advantage. So, a player should play energetically. Suppose, if a player will play passive moves like A3, then black has excellent position. That is why one must play with lot of vigor and energy to, utilize the development. The initiative must be taken to, take advantage, utilize your development advantage. So this is E5. If you delay, black will get counterplay. Once he gets C5, everything is all set for black. Center. So before he could play. This is too late. E6 is coming now. Now there is no time for E6 because now D6 is cracking. King cannot castle. That is why initiative. So knight H6. Of course, this is also white is little better, interesting, but why give a check? Finish. Ignore the C3 knight. Better resign. So the position, I will tell you, this is Faison. In that book's Nunn's book, Understanding Chess Move by Move. I think that book only. So this sort of things comes where you should play. You must not allow the without, if you don't do this move and black is okay here, black will play C5 and pawn into, or D5, B4, black is fine. Now or never, you must play this move with initiative. Understanding Move by Move, Understanding Chess Move by Move by John Nunn. Rouser attack. Now BE7 castle, there are two lines. Rouser attack, basically there are two main lines. One is to play BE7, now castle. Castle. This is a popular line and I think white is little better here. The second line is to play A6 because you can't play BD7, knight B5 is, so you have to play A6 and now castle, bishop D7, idea queen C7, and so this is the second main line, but here A6, this is not the best line nowadays. Better to play queen to c7 or b5 or b5. Now here b5 is one of the most popular line. White plays bishop into knight and now black should play not with queen into, black plays pawn into. So this is a very complicated variation. But he plays in the game h6. A temporary pawn sacrifice, black will get the pawn back. Now, why this move? Because he gets the square. Now, he wants to play, black's idea, want to play bishop here and take the pawn. Three attacks. And h3, he is not afraid. Knight e5 will come. Now, third support has come. Now, the point is, the counting is all right, but king in center, this is the main problem. This is the main problem. Bishop into bishop, check. The king position is jeopardized. After king into, queen f4, check. Finish. Whatever you play, knight or bishop, one piece is gone. Very bad king position. Hopeless position. ये जो वेरिएशन है प्योर नाजडॉर्फ में आता है. सो ब्लैक ट्राइड टू मिक्स अप नाजडॉर्फ, दिस वेरिएशन कम्स. ओके, सो दिस इज बैड, लॉस्ट पोजीशन.
idea queen h4 check. Lost if you play knight into knight and bishop h5 check. Now Archangel, this is the Archangel. In my opinion, Archangel is fully playable because gives very active play, very sharp game comes. Now black has a choice to play caudal defense, bishop c5, caudal or Archangel. So caudal, you have to be ready for knight e5. Now bc5, knight e5 comes. Now bishop b7. Knight e4. Now the position, white has to play energetically, otherwise black will have some initiative. So white must open up the game before black develops and consolidates. c3. Next, also if you are positionally, so you have to take it. Now excellent move, queen f3. Defend. This is the intermediary move and ruins completely black's king's position. Finish. The king is stuck in the center, it will get mated soon. He is simply threatening knight to knight and winning the piece. Queen e2. Now if queen takes, take, take, rook e1 is coming. You get the piece back, you get the piece with a clear better game. One extra piece, lost. So, ye jo hai, ye line, one day I will discuss how I recommend this Archangel. I will discuss how to play black side of Archangel. But not today because it is a long theory. Ye jo line hai, b5 and bb7. I will recommend this for black. Not easy. So, I will recommend, but not today, maybe. Saturday? No, maybe Saturday I can show you this. How to play the Archangel for black. Very sharp lines. One more last game. B2. Actually, you know, Botvinnik in his best game, first one book, in the early 1950s, he just simply said knight g5 is plus minus for the c6 line. The theoretical line here is to play e6. e6 is the main line. In case c4, now the line goes like this. c4, knight comes, knight c3, now bishop e7, castle. Now you can play castle. Now you can play pawn into pawn, pawn into pawn, bishop here. With advantage, maybe bishop f4 also, bishop, because waiting for knight to come so that you can play d5 and pawn into pawn and d5, white stands better because of the weakness. So this is the theory, but when somebody plays c6, Botvinnik's idea is very powerful. Knight here. Now dual threat, not only this is attack, this is also a threat now. Bishop into bishop still does not help. Queen into with attack. If you play bishop takes is worse. Suppose you take, bishop takes, knight into, pawn into. Now c4. If knight here, a4. Why a4? Because the rook will join the attack. Main idea is not the knight. It is not the knight. Main idea, rook will come quickly for attack on the line. And of course, I am giving a threat also. This is one of the idea I want to harass. The main idea, rook coming to third rank with a devastating attack. So this is bad. So here he has to play
No, pawn, pawn into. But now check, it is a disaster. No, this is horrible. The king position is bad. You will lose material. Now, this is now a lot of threats are there. Nc7 threat is there. This is terrible. So, the whole position c6 is bad. You can refer to Botvinnik. Ye abhi dikha sakta hu main. Kidhar hai wo c6? Botu. Strategy of the world champion. So this is the first game I remember having seen this game. Knight castle. No, I think Ng5 one move. No, this is plus. But Ng5 was coming directly. Maybe I am missing that game from here. Maybe I am missing. This is plus. Okay. So friends, because tomorrow I will have the vaccine first dose. So maybe tomorrow, I am not sure I will be totally fit and all right by afternoon after taking the injection. Sometimes fever comes. So I will not take chance. Tomorrow I will take off and I will back on Saturday morning for the next session, 9:30 Saturday. And I will cover that Archangel for black and some interesting end games. Possible. Thank you very much being with me. Sakona Namaskar. Take care.